What do we know? We know, of course, that millions were killed by COVID, but now this new research that you've been reporting on suggesting that heart disease deaths also jumped during the pandemic. What do we know? What are the details?
Right. Well, you have to remember that heart disease has been the leading cause of death for decades at this point. But we were doing really well before COVID came along. Those numbers were declining. And in fact, cancer rates were rising. Then COVID hit and the numbers were, you know, astronomical, how many people died. And so you would have thought that you'd switched out one for the other, right? That COVID deaths were replacing some of these heart disease deaths, especially because the people who were dying from COVID were older and in many cases sick. But that's not what actually was found. In fact, in the U.S., for example, just over the first 3 years of the pandemic, there were 250,000 additional deaths in adults age 35 and older. So we saw not only the COVID deaths that didn't exist prior to 2020, we also saw a surge in these heart disease deaths. So we weren't trading off one for the other, and that's something that we're continuing to see going forward.
Was it just heart disease rates that were worsened by COVID, or were there other ailments that were pressured by this pandemic and this disease?
You know, COVID was terrible for every part of your body. We saw increases in diabetes. We saw increases in stroke. We saw increases in atrial fibrillation. And even things you wouldn't normally tie to something like an infectious disease. We were seeing more Alzheimer's disease, for example, and even cancer. So absolutely, COVID was bad all around every part of our bodies.
Why is that? And what does it mean? And if you were inoculated, if you had the vaccine, were you better protected from some of those factors? What was behind the reason for the uptick in all of those different ailments?
Right. Such a great question. And that's exactly what scientists are trying to get to the bottom of now, right? Because, of course, it wasn't just that people were getting infected and that infection was killing them. That infection was also doing other things to our healthcare system, for example. So people weren't doing things like going to the doctor. They were not getting the cancer screening that they normally would have. And in some cases, healthcare systems were overwhelmed. So they stopped doing things like just any kind of preventative elective surgeries and other types of, you know, emergency rooms were closed, everything was overwhelmed. So there was definitely some fallout from that. But also your other question is also a very hot topic, and that we saw a lot of questions today on our T-Live. People want to know how bad were the vaccines, to what extent was that contributing? And the research is really unequivocal on this. There's no doubt that vaccines did cause some harm, but it was far outweighed by the numbers of lives that were saved from the vaccinations. That's the takeaway message, of course, that the doctors, scientists, researchers want everyone to know. Of course, it is troubling if you're the one on the other end had some kind of a bad side effect from a COVID vaccine. Just like with any vaccine, sometimes that does happen. But again, those benefits, including saving lives, really did offset the risks.